around 10:50, that's 11, 10 minutes to 11 p.m., I received a call from Mr. Fadi Dabbousi to the effect that he has been released and he's home.
Which is on Sunday.
That was yesterday.
Okay.
Now, before then, at dawn on Friday, they returned all the copies of the books that they seized from his residence. Well, that was early signs that the interrogating officers were beginning to see reason. And by the close of day, they had released him. But that was way beyond the 48 hours mandatory period specified under the Constitution. But of course, that his freedom has been secured is history now. So I spoke to him, and as I was sure that he was safely at home, decided again that I'll call him this morning to be sure that they haven't come for him again.
Mm-hmm.
And this morning he confirmed that he was so home. And at about 9 o'clock, I met him today, and he was in high spirits,
mm-hmm.
except for some. You know, he's very fair.
Yeah.
And then the cell that he was held in had mosquitoes, so he was mosquito infested mosquito cell, and so he had to suffer some mosquito bites. So you can see the marks all over his body. But of course, he's fine. He went on a hunger strike.
Oh,
so
really?
For the period that he remained in the BNI custody, he never ate anything. He never drank anything.
I see. But then
there have been reports indicating that he says that BNI treated him well. I think the words were with respect, and so he actually doesn't have any ill feeling about that.
Yeah, that is apart from the fact that the cell conditions, of course, no cell condition is good.
Yeah.
I believe that unless you are talking about the Western countries, he confirms that he was treated with utmost respect. And they treated him with proper courtesy, nobody roughing him up. He was not maltreated, and that has to be placed on record. Yeah, apart from the fact that the circumstances of his arrest and the the fact that he was held incommunicado at some point has been said, it has to also be said that notwithstanding all that, he was treated with utmost respect.
Okay, now, have the BNI officials made known to you exactly what they were after when they ransacked Mr. Dabbousi's home?
From the line of questioning during his interrogation, everything had to do with some articles that he had published on Ghana Web.
Which,
and one of them suggested that the president had put the daughter of Otumfuo Asantehene in the family way.
Okay.
That is what one of the articles suggested. And the other also suggested, and it was more or less like a question that he posed, and it was whether or not the president had HIV/AIDS. It was not a categorical statement that he made. He posed a question. They asked whether he could justify those publications. Now, in his response, he says that the content of those articles were not his original production. He sourced the information from some other media houses, and he made reference to those media publications. So they were not his original ideas. He read them somewhere, and he also incorporated them into his articles. Of course, that is not to say that he will not be held responsible for the content of what he reproduces. But at that point, it had to be stated very clearly that he didn't write the story about the president impregnating the daughter of the Asantehene, and he didn't also start the publication regarding the HIV status of the president. He didn't start. Now, those publications can be critical, they can be damning and all that, but they are not criminal as far as I'm concerned, and they are not the kind of communication that will threaten the security of the nation, that would immediately trigger the jurisdiction of the BNI. We think that by law, the BNI has a mandate to gather intelligence, analyze and disseminate intelligence to various stakeholders, and to secure the borders of the country and to prevent us against any military or civil takeover, and to prevent us against any civil strife or espionage, or drug enforce the drug menace and all that. I believe that there are remedies for such a publication. If anybody believes that the publication is defamatory of his character, first of all, you have a right to a rejoinder. And so you can write a rejoinder to set the record straight and say that you are referencing this article that was published on so and so date which made certain allegations against your person. And then you wish to respond as follows. Then you set the record straight and then you demand all the story. And then you demand that the article should be published by Ghana Web, for instance. And you demand, and then they have to publish it there. Secondly, if you don't wish to go by way of a rejoinder, you can go by way of lodging a complaint at the National Media Commission. National Media Commission will conduct its own investigations. We invite the parties to come and give support to the various positions that they have taken. If at the end of their investigation they see merit in the complaints, then they can ask the person who did the publication to retract and apologize. The other alternative is to go to court. Now, these are remedies that I believe are available to a person who is aggrieved. I do not think resort to the BNI is one of the remedies that are available. Anything that has to do with the BNI would mean that there is a criminality being imputed in that. But there's no criminal libel law regime anymore. And so I believe the fact that the BNI got involved in itself was wrong. They needn't have gotten involved in the first place. Their core mandate is clearly spelled out by law, and they ought to have remained within that remit.
So is this the reason why you intend to sue the security apparatus?
Well, we haven't made that decision yet. When we make that decision, we'll communicate that to the public, and then we'll take the necessary steps that will actualize that position. But for now, I'm still in conversation with my client, and as and when we decide, we'll let you know.